Hello, 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 and welcome to another episode of the Crazy Town Podcast. My name is Jonas, I'm your host, and I'm here with...
TNT, Dynamite, the Explosive One, TNT, DINOMIGHT, what up, Joni?
Yeah, not much, dude, hanging out with you, making a miracle happen every moment of every day with this podcast, though, bro, you know?
You make it sound like we're adopting a child.
Spoiler alert.
What, we're adopting a child? You're getting a cat?
Me and you were adopting a child together. I'm glad you
did. Adopting a cat child?
Cat babies?
Dude, come on.
Nah, dude, get out of here with that. Anyways, thank you so much for joining us today on the Crazy Town Podcast. Whether you're joining us on our YouTube channel on Crazy Town Media or Spotify, iTunes, all that. It's raining like a bee. This guy does Twitch.
TNT Dynamite. I'm on Twitch every single day at 10 o'clock a.m. Central. That's TNT, DINOMIGHT, _ Crazy Sound, twitch.tv.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, boy.
So, what's new with you, man?
Life is good, Jonas, you know?
Yeah, like, pandemic is pretty good.
Any day above ground, though, you know? That's kind of the way I feel about it, boyo.
Yeah, dude. I mean, it could be worse. You could have, like, the mafia after you or something.
Yeah, you know what?
Could have a huge gambling debt and they're coming to break your kneecaps.
I mean, yeah, you know, I could not have clean water to drink.
Yeah,
dude. That's something, you know.
Yeah, absolutely.
Could not have food to eat at all. I could be dying from, like, rubella.
Sure.
Just saying, you know.
Measles, mumps, or rubella. MMR, dude.
It's, you know, we could live in a country where they don't sell pants.
We could live in a country where they... Never mind. I heard you have some stories for us today, huh?
What are you talking to me like we're on the television show? I mean, I can tell the story. I have one goddamn story, all right?
That's it, dude?
What the hell?
You're bringing a burnout piece of...
Look, we discussed this off camera.
I know.
So this actually did not happen in America, but the story's been making its rounds.
Oh yeah, dude. It's a good one too.
This happened in Vietnam.
Yep.
345,000 condoms.
Yes.
Were found.
That's a third of a million.
Were found in a facility, Jonas.
Yeah, dude.
A condom making facility.
Usually, if they make condoms, they're in the facility.
Yeah, but there was a funny thing about these condoms.
They had a rainbow pattern on them.
No, that was a good guess though.
Give me another one.
I like this improv.
You know, they had horns.
Condom with horns. I'm picturing it. I kind of like it. Ribbed for her pleasure.
I was gonna say, was it ribbed for her pleasure?
Like the horns could be like near the base so that it kind of like tickles the... Honestly, Jones, we might want to look into this.
Oh yeah, dude, put a little bit of
vibrating horns,
woohoo dilly in the cha-cha, you know what I mean?
Yeah, some vibrating horns on. What else? No, but that's not the right answer either. Give me one more, because rule of threes, Jonas, you gotta have three.
Oh dude, maybe they got them somewhere else and didn't make them there.
They were not cinnamon flavored either, Jonas. I was thinking cinnamon flavored too,
dude. Cinnamon Toast Crunch flavored condoms, dude.
Keep
it out of my girl's mouth, dude.
Burn the roof of your mouth. All right, no, these condoms were found in a facility that was cleaning and repackaging these condoms for resale.
Yep, they were used.
They were used.
If you didn't catch the innuendo.
So the thing is, hold on, Jonas.
Yeah?
Why was she doing this? You may ask.
No, I didn't wonder that, but yeah, go ahead.
You didn't wonder why?
No.
Apparently, this person was being paid by the kilogram.
Yep.
For each kilogram, which is I don't know how much that 360 kilograms were, and it's 794 pounds.
794 pounds of condoms.
Of condom meat.
Did you see how much money she got per kilogram?
How much was it?
17 cents.
That's pretty good though.
If for Vietnam, dude, I bet, dude. It's probably I wonder what one of their Viet bucks is worth. I don't know what
V-Bucks
V-Bucks are worth. in America. So I mean, jeez, it could have been a really hefty V buck.
You did make it sound like
what
just
was
like,
V bucks from?
That's from Fortnite.
Oh, okay.
Did make it sound like video game currency, Viet bucks.
Viet bucks.
Your Vietnam so, fun bucks.
So a little bit of extra information.
Oh, I had more, but yeah, go ahead.
I had this one too.
I know.
What the lady had told them was that they received a monthly input of used rubbers from an unknown person.
Yo. Yo.
So this guy rolls up with like a garbage bag full of used condoms. Why? Every week.
Why
like,
are you keeping used
here
condoms?
You go. Maybe he works at a rub and tug parlor. And he like brings all the
rub and tug parlor. I'm not familiar with this.
One of those $5, you know. Happy
no, I know. You say you know, like I would know. No,
now, you've heard of a happy ending massage parlor before?
Isn't that illegal, Jonas? I don't know
in Vietnam. It's probably not.
You almost called it Korea, you racist. Oh, yes. We were just talking about Korea off cam, but no, dude, I look. I don't understand why they would keep the condoms, though. I don't understand. Aren't they?
He obviously was an entrepreneur. He was like, listen, we have all these used condoms. I can just throw these in the garbage. Or I could take them to Sue over here at the factory.
And re-clean them.
Oh, I have the process. They would boil them.
Yeah, they boiled them.
Then they would dry and reshape them over wooden phalluses. They got wooden dicks all over the factory. She's just rolling these boiled rubbers over wooden dicks. They're curating them, dude. They probably got a nice, like, nice greenhouse sort of like hydroponics. Honestly,
Jonas, when you say it, that the process is, you know, relatively sterile, they're boiling them.
Yeah, right.
And they're reshaping it. My question is like, I mean, isn't this like a viable option?
Are they putting lube back on them, dude? Because dry rubbers, that's going to hurt when you try to put it on, dude. At least every rubber has a little bit of, like, lubrication.
You could drop a dab in there.
I wonder if she's sitting there with, like, spermicidal lubricant, like, giving it a fan down before she rolls them back up and pops them inside a...
Just a bottle of hand sanitizer, just giving each condom a squirt.
Just like a sundae, just a little squirt of sani on the top. It runs down the side. Good enough, dude.
Just standing there with a pipette just dripping.
I wonder how long it took her to get the proper like roll-up feature. Like, did somebody buy one of these condoms and they're like, this doesn't look rolled up like a normal. It's like,
yeah, but
just twisted in a bow.
Okay, so the way I see it, at least like the business model for this, because I think honestly that they're providing a service that isn't provided, which is condoms,
hand-me-down condoms
at a premium, and for the environmentally conscious.
I wonder if they're charging the same price.
You can. How could you? How could you?
It's like the Goodwill of condoms, dude.
Exactly. Well, not even that. It's like the food club of not even food club. It's like it's not recycling, but it's like reusing something. You know.
Yeah,
like,
dude.
Like, they do this with plastics all the time. They take plastic, shred them up, and then they make new plastic. Or paper. They shred the paper up, they make new paper.
Yeah,
now we're just taking your dick sleeve.
But I think this is more of like the Goodwill model. Because they take something that's already used, they clean it, and then sell it again.
Oh. And they sell it a little cheaper.
Yeah, I mean, of course, dude. I mean,
so, yeah, Jonas, if you only got $5 in your pocket, and the box of condoms that you want is $6.75...
Right.
And then you look over and you see...
The guy with a jacket opens them up and he's just like...
I got these gently used.
I mean...
Gently.
Sometimes it's hard enough to get someone to put one on in general.
Yeah.
And people will put like a sandwich bag over their stuff. People will just like... So I really don't think that like, honestly, I would never wear one. But there's people out there who would be like, yeah, dude, whatever.
I mean, I'm just saying. I don't think there's a lot of dudes out there that are going to be like, yeah, whatever, if the other option is a brand new sterile condom. But, you know.
Like, yeah, dude.
I feel like it's a service out there for, you know, the penny pincher and all of us.
I wonder, like, you know what the weird thing about the article? It did not state if anyone was imprisoned for this.
I don't think it's illegal, though. Like
here it probably is. Because don't they got to be FDA approved?
FDA approved condoms?
Yeah, dude, aren't they approved by the Federal Dick Association?
No, you make a good point. They do.
I mean, but they probably don't have that in Vietnam.
Well, we don't know, but you know, I mean, if it made like national news, it's a problem over there for sure.
Yeah, dude, I wonder.
They don't make national news for nothing.
I wonder what their president has to say.
Vietnamese president?
Yeah, dude.
I don't even know if they have one. What does he look like?
Is he a dictator? Like? Are they communist?
I don't know anything about Vietnam.
They won the war, so I think they kept their communism.
Sure.
I don't know, dude. I don't know enough about that area. Would that be called the Pacific Southwest?
I don't know where Vietnam is. So why do you keep asking me questions about geography and world
this
leaders?
This happened in Vietnam, Florida. Just saying.
There you go. Truth, not fact. So, but look, if I don't know, I'm not going to say anything to...
Yeah, I feel you. Would you wear a used condom?
Like I said, Jonas, if I were in a pinch, you know, pinching pennies, I'm in a financial pinch.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just gotta like slide that bad boy on, pray to God, and keep it moving.
You ever flip it inside out, wash it
off? No. Oh my God. And I know this is a thing. I know this is a thing because we both know it exists out there. That's nuts,
dude.
Have you ever used the same condom twice?
Nope. Absolutely not. Like here's kind of my mindset.
I mean, like, dude, you wake up in the morning and it's on, you're like, hey, might
you
as well.
Wake up and it's still on. I just got one on before I go on my date just in case I need it.
Sometimes you let one off and you just fall asleep. Jonas, you ever just fell asleep?
I guess, yeah.
Not all of us want to bust one and then go freaking clean the house. Some of us need a nap. It's a lot of work.
Yeah, dude, it takes a lot of time to brew up a storm like that, you know?
All
right. No, dude, I've never used one twice.
Yeah, I've definitely heard stories of people using the same condom twice, flipping it and doing another chick with like, oh, and you know, or even like dude sharing a condom. Oh, I know this has happened.
That
I know.
Is gross.
It's dude, gross.
Here's
but
my here's my thing though, man.
If it's like a trusted friend.
If you yeah, dude.
The look you gave me.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, I mean, I guess. Look. But here's the thing, like if your issue is that you don't have the other $1.50 to get a brand new condom, you should readjust your life priorities.
No, Joni, cuz pussy is free, all right?
Okay.
And that everybody deserves it.
Wow.
It's already bad that the 1% is already taking everything else, Jonah. We can't let them have pussy, too. All right.
What about condoms? They take those?
Yes. That's why we need an alternative, a cost-efficient alternative. I say use condoms for everybody.
You take them.
All right.
You wear one, you tell me how they work, and then I'll think about
it. In fact, Jonas, whenever you... Ew. Okay, never mind. It almost got too real.
Yeah, dude.
I was just about to tell you to start saving yours, and that's just...
Oh, I would have to be having sex for that to happen. Oh, zing, double zing.
Oh, heart.
Dude.
Yeah.
I was watching... I didn't watch this game, but the Denver Broncos are a football team. I have two football stories.
Yeah.
And we all know that we have a little thing called a pandemic going on, so they're limiting the amount of people that can come into a stadium. They're letting a few in here or there. The Denver Broncos filled up an entire section of their stadium with cardboard cutouts of the entire town of South Park.
Oh, really?
Did you see that?
I did not see that.
Yeah, I don't know like if it was literally every character they've ever had, but I saw a picture, and there was like tens of them. So, like, there was quite a few different people represented in the in the thing. I guess they did it because, I guess, just kind of, like, as a tribute to – because Trey Parker and Matt Stone are, like
– They're from there?
They went to – that's where they met at college, I guess. Was it University of Colorado or something? Ooh. And they and they're big Denver Broncos fans. I think they had that one episode where Cartman's mom fucked the whole Denver Broncos team or something.
I
like,
recall that.
Yeah, so, yeah, I thought that was cool.
It's pretty cool.
And then I'll piggyback that off of another story. So since there's not any fans in the stadium or very little, I have noticed watching football that the the networks are piping in crowd noise over the broadcast.
Yeah, well, they have to.
So they, you know, they're doing a little bit of like defense. No, I didn't hear that. But you do hear like the, you know, the crowd noise.
They do that in NBA games too.
Yeah, yeah. I even noticed that they did it on wrestling a little bit. Mm-hmm. They're trying to pipe it. Keep it as, because like, to be completely honest, sports don't look a ton different without fans because most of the time they're focused on the action.
Yeah.
It's just a matter of like flipping to the stadium and then panning and stuff like that. But
yeah.
Like watching a wrestling match, watching a football game, it looks pretty much the same for the most
it
part.
It really does.
But so in Philadelphia, two different times the Eagles failed to get a third down, and whoever was controlling, they were playing at home, whoever was controlling the noise put fake boos over the broadcast for the home team.
That's probably par for the course.
Well, yeah, Eagles fans are known for being like really hard on their own team. Hey. And like it was like, and he missed a third down throw, and you could hear boo. Like I it was like a little thing on Twitter. I hit the clip, and you sure as fuck could hear them booing him.
Yeah.
There was no one in the stadium, and then they did it again later in the game, dude.
Hell yeah, dude.
How would you like to be the guy on like the Fox broadcast that you're just like, boo?
Look, he was keeping it real. He was giving them exactly the treatment they would get if the fans were actually there. I respect that.
Yeah.
I hope they're piping booze in at the Browns Stadium.
Oh, God, they sure as F better be. You know, dude.
Just the whole
speaking
game.
Speaking of which.
Just no cheers, this, all booze.
The Browns may have lost again since this one comes out, but the Browns have a winning record for the first time in six seasons right now. They're 2-1, dude. It said the game said it's been
been
6 years since they had a more wins than losses in their record.
It's so funny to me that like I've lived a long time in Ohio and I lived a long time in New York. You fucking Browns fans and you fucking New York Giants fans are always the same. This is our year. We got a winning record this year, dude. We're gonna do it.
Nope. No, I was just saying they finally have more wins than losses for once.
Yeah, I guess.
They ain't winning, dude. They'll probably end the season with two wins. They got two now, and that's it. But
they might play again.
You know what else I heard today? I have not read the story entirely, so this is truth, not facts. They have determined that there is water on Mars.
This is a departure from football story, yeah, absolutely. But all right.
Yeah, but
I believe this has been
talked
about.
It was breaking news today.
This has been talked about before,
it's confirmed, though.
Well, now it's confirmed.
Yeah, they got, they got, you know, they got this like little rover thing, dude, and they're all like, "Oh, bro, there's salt under the surface, like water and stuff, dude."
They got this little rover thing, dude. No, don't get too scientific with them.
Dude, I didn't read the article. I'm trying to cover time for the end of the episode.
I know, dude. I just love it. I love giving you a hard time about it. All right, so yeah, they have the rover. There's water on Mars. There's been talks about Elon wanting to maybe inhabit Mars.
Oh yeah, he definitely wants to inhabit it. But
Mars,
like,
is closer to the sun than us, though, right?
No, they're farther away.
They're further away, so it would be cold.
It would be cold as a bee there, dude.
It's already cold here, dude. Like, is it inhabitable cold?
I don't think so, dude. I think that's kind of the thing I remember from like growing up, that like Mars was too cold and Venus was too hot and had all them clouds and whatnot.
Yeah, so I think like if it's too cold, like obviously he'd be thinking about like if we were going to ever inhabit Mars, which may honestly, Jonas, the way we're treating the planet right now and the ozone layer and shit, scientists know shit's getting a little crazy, and I think that's more a reason that we're hearing rumblings of some of these multi-billionaires wanting to with the SpaceX and nurturing these space programs so that we can evacuate. These multi-billionaires are like, hey, look, I've got generational wealth, endless supplies of money. I think maybe we should start thinking about getting my family, my descendants off of this fucking planet when it finally blows up.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Like, I don't, like, it would take so long to, like, it's like, if so obviously they would have to build structures that would be completely airtight, that you would have to pump oxygen in, right?
Just like any other space station, though.
And it takes so long to get to Mars from here. Like, it takes, like, years, I think.
Yeah.
So like, so you fly all these supplies out there to build, and you like, and you like forget some screws, dude.
That's your problem. Is that what if they forget some screws?
Yeah, dude. They're gonna be like, you gotta wait 10 years to build another little pod, dude.
I guess they could forget some screws. No, I mean, would be more concerned with the fact of it is the unknown and that you really don't know like what down there could just be.
Oh, they all gonna die.
Absolutely caustic to the human genome.
Well, because the other thing, it's like, it's weird because it's gonna have to be like. Like when you start a new game in Minecraft, because they're going to have to build like a little like 10 by 10 airtight hut. Then they're going to have to like go from there and like expand a little bit.
Expand a little.
Because they got to be somewhere where they can be safe. Like, and you got to start somewhere. It's like.
So I think essentially, like, I know it's probably like it's we won't be alive for when any of this shit happens. But this is kind of like the beginning of what like. The fantasy of like Star Trek or something started off with. It was like a private company was like, look, we need to get some spaceships up there. All right. So it starts out with rockets and well, we're just making fun trips up there.
Yeah.
Tom Cruise is supposed to be doing a movie in space. He's working with he's been working with SpaceX, I believe, or NASA, actually. He's actually been on the space station that we have up there now. We already have a fucking functional space station.
The world. I think the world shares it because I think there's Russians and like
we already have it.
Yeah.
So like, and it's obviously it ain't as comfortable as anything Star Trek has ever put up there. Dude.
Oh
it's,
yeah, absolutely.
It's pretty basic, but it, yeah, I don't know, man. So look, man, it's the final frontier. It's the one thing we don't have any control over. We don't know much about it at all.
Yeah, we ain't gonna see that though.
No, it's unfortunate, but I'm cool with it.
You know, I don't think we're gonna see the really bad struggles of climate change either. Because I think like it's gonna start happening, but I think we'll be like old and dead before it like really makes a huge impact. Like makes it close to unlivable.
Yeah. So you're saying is that that's probably gonna be the be all end all that makes this planet uninhabitable?
Well, I mean, if it gets to the point where like. It's so hot that all the ice caps melt and sea level rises and drives all the people even closer together than they are now because all the coastal cities will be gone. And then it's hot. So, like, you can't cool down. You can and you can only produce so much electricity to provide so much cooling. And then, like, eventually it's just going to be even more draining and even more draining. It's just going to – it's like you won't even be able to, like, walk – you'll have to, like, run from your house to the car to turn on air conditioning to turn – you know, it's like you're going to have to, like
– I mean, the summers will be crazy and the winters will be crazy. And that's got a lot to do with, like, water being very conductive of energy.
Yeah.
Whether it be warmth or cold. So.
Well, here's the other thing.
It's just, yeah.
If the planet's hotter, it's going to cause more evaporation of the ocean, which is going to cause more water in the air, which is going to cause humidity to get higher, which is just going to make the temperature higher. It could cause way crazier storms. Oh, and like,
definitely.
Like, so it's going to, I mean, people are just like, oh, dude, whatever, ice. You're like, no, dude, it very much affects the entire ecosystem.
Yeah, my thing is like, if these multi-billionaires, these endless just pits of money that we call people, if they're looking into it, there must be a reason. And usually these people only make moves for one of two reasons, either life-threatening.
Or they can make a bunch of money. Yeah, because that Richard Branson dude, he's doing like private space flights. They're going to start testing stuff soon.
Yeah, exactly.
And
they're hoping to get a deal when the world finally realizes, hey, look, this shit is crazy. We got to go. Hey, I already got a company that does that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
You give me a big multi-billion dollar grant because who doesn't need more billions of dollars?
Yeah, dude, you already have billions. Let me just give you more to do more rich man stuff.
It's like, it is, man. So, yeah, get your SpaceX on.
Yeah,
you should start building freaking rockets, Jonas.
Yeah, let's start a company.
All right.
I got like a grand.
Do you?
Is that enough to like start a company?
Maybe a small loan of $1 million will get us there.
Might as well go for $1 billion. No. They're giving out billions to Branson. Why aren't they giving out billions to us?
I mean, pretty sure he made billions.
Oh, yeah. Takes money to make money.
Yeah, didn't he like sell telephones?
Shit. Yeah, he sold virgins.
Yeah. Fair enough.
But that's all the time we have for today's episode. Please make sure to like and subscribe. If you already done that, this dude does Twitch things.
TNT Dynamite, I'm on Twitch every single day at 10 o'clock a.m. Central. That's TNT DINOMIGHT_CrazyTown to twitch.tv.
for joining us. We'll catch you on the next one. We are out.